back end of growth can do it too. And everybody else, later on when you snuggle in, and I know you will, trace the cross on his forehead. All right. Godparents, you gotta lean over and... Now this was a reading from the beginning, the very first chapter of the Holy Gospel according to Mark. If you'd like to follow along with the pictures in that window right there. Jesus came from Nazareth of Galilee on the day of Jesus' baptism. The voice from heaven thundered, "This is my beloved Son with whom I am well pleased." And isn't that the same song of joy that's welling up in the heart of parents here today and indeed in all of us? This is our beloved Son in whom we are well pleased. Now remember what had happened to Jesus up to this point in the Gospel of Mark. Nothing. Mark doesn't have the infancy narratives about Bethlehem and wise men and all the rest. The Gospel starts by Jesus, fully adult, being baptized in the Jordan River by John. After this comes all of his preaching and teaching, his miracles and healings. After this comes his glorification and transfiguration and all of that. And after this also comes the passion, suffering, cross. Let's take George as a good example here. What's happened in his life up till now? Other than a little pooping and spitting up, not a whole lot. All of the wonders of learning, growing up, his college degree, that doctorate you earned, you know, the world-famous headlines, and the suffering. He's going to scrape his knee. He is going to get a bobo every now and then. Everything that lies ahead of him, again, is still in the future. What sustained Jesus in the bad times? And the sufferings and his passion. What added to the joy and the greatness of his mighty deeds? That loving relationship he had with